Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to demonstrate how you can create and manage dashboards and how you can put your reports on dashboards. Before starting, if you want to watch more Salesforce training videos, you can go to description of this video and you will find links of various playlists. So those playlists contain various Salesforce videos, so you can follow them. Now I'm coming to the topic. So I have these two reports already created, so I'm going to put them on dashboard. So I'm clicking on dashboard tab. Now I'm going to create new dashboard. So whenever you are going to create new dashboard, you need to put a name, description, and you need to select in which folder you want to store that dashboard. So let's say name of dashboard is account dashboard. I'm not putting any description as of now. And if you choose private dashboard, then you cannot use that dashboard outside that folder, because that is private folder. So instead of using private folder, you can create your own folder, or you can store in any folder that is not private. So let's say I'm creating new folder, account dashboard, clicking on save. So I'm choosing this folder, and in this folder, this dashboard will be stored. So now new dashboard is ready so that we can put our reports. So I'm clicking on this plus sign. So from here, we can choose a particular report. So I'm clicking on this report, selecting it. Now here you can see, this is the checkbox. If your report is already having any chart, so you can click on this checkbox, so your chart will be automatically selected. If you want to choose any other type of chart, like these two type of bar chart, then these are stacked horizontal and vertical bar charts. This is line chart, pie chart, matrix, gauge. This is funnel chart, this is scatter chart, and this is a lightning table. So whatever you want to choose, you can pick from here. Let's say we want to use this bar chart. So we can pick, then X, Y axis, you can set display units, decimal places, sort by. So these are other options you can choose accordingly. You can also choose a theme, like if you want to show it in dark theme, so you can choose that as well. So I'm choosing light theme, clicking on add. So here you can see your first report as a component is placed here. Now I'm choosing same report again. So you can place a same report more than one time. Like here, I want to show the number of records those are available in that report on the dashboard. So I'm choosing this. And again, here you can see various options are available. So you can put segmentation range as well. Like you can put particular color accordingly. Then let's say this time I'm choosing this theme. So you can simply drag and drop your component so that you can place them as per the desired location. So here it is. Now, this time I'm going to choose another report. And let's say I'm choosing this Gauss chart. Clicking on add, so it is also available here. Right? So this way you can put your reports as a component. I'm choosing this again. And this time I'm choosing lightning table, right? So this is lightning table, which is created automatically. Again, you will see various options, like which field you want to, or which column you want to include. If you want to apply any grouping, sort by, display unit. So these kind of features are available. You can choose them accordingly and click on add. So here you can see it is available. So I'm moving this downwards. Now I'm clicking on save. So here you can see this way your dashboard will look. So you can place your dashboard on home page or anywhere like on app page, wherever you want to use it. And whenever you use your dashboard, just click on refresh so that the latest information will be displayed. And if you want to view your report, so you can just click on this link, so your reports will be opened. So I am opening it in a new tab. So you can just click on that link and your report will be opened so that you can see the records details also. So here you can see the report is opened and it is showing all the details of the records. So this way, I hope you understood how we can place reports in different way on dashboard. One more thing that is important, I'm clicking on edit. And here you will see three options, view dashboard as. So if I choose me, so it will be displaying records as per my sharing setting. If I choose another person, so I can choose a particular user and a dashboard will show the values or data as per the selected user's sharing setting. And if I choose this third option, the dashboard viewer, so whosoever is the logged in user, accordingly data will be displayed. And if you want to give permission, like you can change user dynamically while viewing the dashboard, so you can check this checkbox as true. Then we have other options which are very simple, like column, you can choose accordingly. So now if I'm clicking on save, done, save. So that error was coming because in developer edition, we can create three dashboard having this option, like we can choose user dynamically. So I deleted one dashboard. So now I'm clicking on done. So here you will see, I'm clicking on refresh. So here you can see this change option is available. So if you click on this, so you can choose another user and you can click on apply. So as per this user's sharing setting, the reports will be displayed. So here you can see this report is not showing anything and this report is showing the data, because maybe in this report you I have used the filter, like I can show records related to a particular user. Like we have options like all accounts or my account, so you can do changes on those reports so that you can view the data as well. So as per the filter conditions and as per the sharing setting, these things will work. So you have three options, like you can use creator, you can use the logged in user, or you can change the user dynamically, right? And or you can select a particular user through which you want to develop. As per the sharing setting of that user, you want to display your dashboard. So this way, I hope you understood how we can place our reports on dashboard. And if you want to share your dashboard with another user, so you can select your dashboard. So this is our dashboard folder and it is having account dashboard. So from here, I can share this dashboard with other users so that they can access. So you can choose any user role, role in subordinates or public group. So accordingly, your dashboard will be shared and this dashboard can be used by other users. So this way, I hope you understood how we can create dashboard, how we can manage dashboard, and how we can put reports on dashboard. So thank you for watching this video.